Hi folks, this was an acrylic demonstration I did on YouTube 4 years ago. Oh, 4 years in April. I'm going to do something like that, the snow scene. I forgot I'd done it, I don't know where it is. I've got seven or eight packages of watercolor demonstrations, acrylic and oil demonstrations in the loft space above this loft room. I wouldn't know where to start to look for these things. I didn't really paint them with a view to selling them. They were demonstrations and on YouTube and our Patreon. Now I've got a shop on Etsy, where if this turns out okay, I'll put it up for sale. Now this is a small stay wet palette, the Masterson range. It doesn't seem to be anywhere near as good as the large one I use. It's much harder plastic. But it's good. These colours have been on this palette for well over a week now, and they're still moist. I'm not going to describe the colours. They're the reds, blues, yellows, the green. I'll probably want some burnt sienna. Well, now the burnt sienna is very, very good for not these particular burnt siennas, but put that down there. It's too light. The Winsor & Newton is the best burnt sienna I've come across in any medium. It's a lovely, very dark red. So let's start. Let's just whack in a sky, using a nice brush, a Georgian De La Rowney long flat. Nice brush. I've primed this water, this demonstration I did the other day, but I don't particularly like it. It's a good demonstration, but it wasn't a very good, it's not a seller, so we're just going to paint over that. Palette's a bit black from the black that I used. Let's just put in some light sky. Just cover up the paper. It's a bit muddy because of the colour of my palette underneath. I haven't really cleaned it well. I'm too stingy to throw the paint away. Although most of these, with the exception of the white and the yellow ochre, are store own brand, mostly Wilkinson's. They're cheap and cheerful, but they're okay. There they work. I usually prime with, if I bother, with some burnt sienna pop, cut with a bit of PVA glue. I'm going to put a bit of a lighter cloud in there now. Want to counter change against that. We're going to come down there with the snow. That's lovely starting a new painting. It's when it gets into the advanced stages, it all goes wrong. But you'll find that your paintings will, you'll lose them, then you'll find them again as you progress. A touch of red in there. So I can counter change the trees against the light with a bit of purpley stuff behind here. put it to you. So it's a miserable day in London. Well, probably all over the country. It's nothing to what North America has been experiencing. Not just knocking up a bit of light colour. I'm not using pure white, I'm using white mixed with a bit of red and a bit of yellow ochre. I use yellow ochre in acrylic and oil, but not in watercolour, it's too opaque. Right, that's a start. Now I want to lighten the top up there, but I'm going to put a lighter blue in, but I'm going to just get some purple colour behind where we're going to put the trees. So just a red and blue, a bit of white. It's a bit darker than that. To be sort of misty trees in the distance. Just blend it a little bit. Wanted quite a low horizon, a lot of sky. Easier to do sky than landscape. Just background colours. Now, when the paint's not dry and you paint over it, it just dissolves it. So we'll move somewhere else from that. Clean the brush. Oh, very windy. I hope the picture is not too yellow. I've got a halogen heater up here. And my LED lights above, they're not sort of day bright, they're slightly warmer than that. But they seem to be working okay. Right, I'm going to put in a bit of dark stuff here, so a bit of blue. So a bit of some blue in there. So just the horizon colours. This will all be changed. This is just a roughing in. A soften. And we get some snow in there underneath all that. So the beauty about acrylic is that you can work fast. It dries pretty quickly. The paper. I was asked about stretching paper for watercolour. I don't pre-stretch the paper, a waste of time. When the paper expands, just pull it tight and reclip it. I'm talking about watercolours here. And it will go completely flat. Okay, so let's get some slightly bluey white, the ochre white as well. I will just a nice bit of light catching on there. So still, I'm going to put a bit of that bluey grey in. You need some dark in the snow. Snow isn't always white. It reflects the colours around it. I finished my drink. Yep. Bovril. A good English drink. I'm going to give that a bit of a dry. A quick dry with the hairdryer. So for that, I'll have to mute the sound. Okay, back to the sky now. So we want a nice blue sky. I'll just get this a bit of a clean, this palette, a bit of a clean, where all this dark I painted. I don't want to sully the sky. Okay, right. Need plenty of cloth and plenty of. Oh, I'm using the wrong. No, that's the right one. And paper and cloth for this. Right, let's get the blue in. So the nice blue, bit of white. The brush has got quite a bit of water on it. And the ultramarine is pretty thin. Watercolor paper makes a lovely support for oil and acrylic. Quite well, the Constable Turner used it. And they're as fresh today as they were when they painted them a couple of 100 years ago. Just filling in the holes. This, as against this light colour, I'm going to superimpose my trees. So my clouds are more yellow ochre than white. I've got to merge all that. With the blue, so I'm going to go back with the blue, clean the brush, clean it out, squeeze all the moisture, all the water out. There's enough in the colours. There we are. There's my palette. Blue, white. It was a big palette, I might have two piles of yellow, one for colours, the dark colours, and one for the lighter colours. I have to go back to that because it's picking up the colour from underneath. But I just want to soften around the edge of these. Okay, that's all right. Let's go back to down here now and get some of that nice mauve. Right, when that dries off a bit, I can blend the sky back into it. Then we can start modelling the trees. Oops. Just putting some light back into that there, so it's just toned down a little bit. They're picking up the colour there, which we don't really want to do. Yeah, that's picking up that colour from underneath. So we'll just work a bit on this area here now. We'll find a brush for that. So bit of yellow ochre, bit of red, bit of black even. Some dark on that horizon there, so I'll mix a bit of blue and a bit of black into that umbery colour. Put a lot of lights and darks back in. It makes my wrist hurt doing this. I try and hold a pen sometimes. I really cramp up the arthritis in the hands. When you see my hands covered in bandages, the brushes taped to the right Renoir. Think of it as Renoir. And I've got to put lights back in there. Put some white back in with that amber here. Vary the colours in this undergrowth here. Shake the brush. I still need to get that colour dry. Get some light back in there, some mauvey light. So the darker trees will show up, but these are going to be more distant. I'm more or less copying the one that I did all those years ago, 4 years ago. A rerun. So you can see what's happening now. I'm putting in the distant trees, but much of it's going to be covered up. But just feather it slightly, just get it a bit lighter at the top, so it blends more into the background. Right, let's go back and get some of that down into there now. So that sort of becomes a focal point in there. Doesn't show and I'll modify it. And all the time I'm building up some sort of impasto or serve some thickness on the paper. Some light back in that. Get some blue and that mauve colour, more on the blue side, back in here. We'll let that dry a bit. So now we want to start to model some trees. I'm going to use a flat brush for that. It's my old watercolour brush, which I've more or less worn out. It's a short flat. I bought this years ago when I went back to watercolours. But I will have like a grey, the blue for a grey. I will. And into that, we'll put in some bluey colours. A silver birch in here. Done a bit too spindly. Because the branches on these silver birches are very spindly. I'll prefer use of rigor as well. But I'll wait for that to dry off a little bit. A bit burnt sienna, a bit of white. I'm only going to put one of those in, I think. So once you've built up some brush marks on the acrylic here, you can, when it's dry, you can dry brush over it. That's just a rough laying. Try and rigger. Right, a bit of water now. So we've got a bit of blue, a bit of amber. We'll put a bit of ivy and stuff on here and snow and all sorts of stuff. Sort of the bark. Not sure I like the thickness of that. I've gone over a bit too far there. See if we can just draw that back. Another little brush. Oh, hear the wind. Keep your brushes very, very clean, and particularly where the bristles meet the ferrule. That's the metal bit. That's where you get a build up of unclean paint in there, and it eventually splits the brush, opens it all over the place. Right, bit of dark in there. Right, that's going to be lost in a melee of ivy. We got Dyna bws gen i, Steffi. We'll have a bit of dark green, I think. I'll put more twigs coming out of this. How's that coming on? Still a bit damp. Have a look at the picture, see what we're coming up with. Starting to work a little bit. Got a lot of work to do in that tree, but it's just getting some paint on. Let's put in some more of that lighter greeny colour. Put some greens in there. We have worn these brushes. Can put bits of snow in there. Black is a very useful colour. Good shortcut. Once you've got the colour on, when it dries a bit, you can do all sorts of lovely things with it. Some lighter. Right now, what's a brush that I can? All my brushes with acrylic are all well past their sell by date, but they work. So I want to put in some blue, bit of umber, mostly on the blue side. So we can do some nice blue shapes, or blue, dark blue shapes. A bit more white in there. As we just go down, just putting these shapes in. Yeah, a bit of a disaster with the horse racing fraternity. Horses have been found with equine flu, so they've had to cancel a lot of meetings. Come on, come over a bit too far with that. Right, just. Oops. Got some up there. So that's our canopy. I'm going to put some rigger work into that. Sort of stippling now. I'm going to put some ochre in there. Just put some in there, some grey. I think we've got a bit round there. I'm going to put some sky back in that, open it up a little bit, same as here. Gale force winds now. This would be okay by the time I put some stipple over it. Trying to get a bit of thin paint on this rigger. Oops. All right, get my stipple brush. You've got a lot of this in the English or the British countryside, where old oaks or trees have got covered with ivy, and some haven't died. Some darks in there. A little bit of dark under there now. So blue and umber. It's going to take a while, so you can always fast forward through what you the boring bits. clean the brush and dry the brush. And I'll just go back with a bit of sky colour. Change the shape of some of that, lose a bit of it. Make our way through there. In the murk. Ah, we lost it, didn't we? Just lose some of that. Change the shape somewhat, put some air back in some of that. And we got a bit of white colour in here. I'll move away from there for a minute. Oh, well, no, I won't. I'm going to put in some light umber and a bit of sienna. Some warmer colour in there. Misty. So far, so not so good. This is where we want the sort of blue, dark blue. Well, darken the sky then. I have to wait for this to dry a bit. Plenty of water when you do this, otherwise it'll just, the brush will just don't like that. No, I'll just take that bit out. That I'd need probably a smaller brush. What's that one like? No, still too wet there. Let's go back on the snow. I think we can afford to do that. There's just a bit of light showing through there. Now, I'm not sure whether the light's coming from the front or from the back, but we'll put in some shadow, sort of coming down here. An old brush of here. Bit of grey. Getting some snow back in here. Now, just little bits of the snow, sort of just on the ivy or here and there. Some trunks or twigs, branches catching the. Oh, I hope that's turned off. We're still going. Right, I can see something that I encourage you not to do. I seem to have copied that there, so we're going to have to change that. But I want to do a bit of work on that tree first. Touch of blue in there. It sort of represents the bark sort of peeling. Oh, silver birches are just lovely. Well, let's get some darks, get some umber in there. Right, I'm just going to go back over the top of that. Clean the brush. A bit of detail, a bit of work on the snow. Then we'll call that one done, I think. Okay, here we go. Too wet. It would help if I used artist quality paints, they'd be much more body. But considering how much I paint, it all gets very expensive and it will cost. How's that? That's a bit better. Brighten up some of that. Right, that's a better shape. Okay, a bit of burnt sienna, a bit of white. shape's gone on that base of that again, so we're going to just change some of that. So a bit of dark behind there. Bit of dark shadow in there. Okay, coming on. Let's see if I can lose a bit of that, bit too dark. Try and get rid of any nasty shapes. A bit of blue back in here. And have a bit of ochre, a bit of white. Just adding some mystery to that, and we'll get some lighter. Coming down here. Okay, now we do a bit of the snow here. Let's deepen that shadow. Oh, sheeting down. Then we can put the white or the off-white. Well, let's put out an amount. I think we've been on that long enough. Let's put a bit of tape across the top here. Now that paper stayed perfectly flat, although I had two of it on one side. Let's have a dark mountain map. No, I don't like that. Let's have the light colour. Oh, there we are. With these clips. Oh. Well, really, I don't think we can do much more than that. I just hope this has as recorded in one piece with it and so forth for some reason. So there we are. A snow scene. I could do a lot more work on it, but it's a demonstration, so I'm going to let that go. I'll sign it, and maybe if I think it's any good, I'll put it on the up for sale on Etsy. So think, if I was doing this for myself, and I hadn't done a painting myself since I started YouTube, I would spend a lot more time on it. So I'd give it much more finish. But then I'm only showing them for nominal sums of money. About £40, £50 plus post and package, wherever you live, on Etsy. Or you can go and look at all my videos on Patreon. I must have over 300 on there. Anyway, thanks for persevering with that one, guys. I think I could probably just put in a little bit of dark on the base of that, because we've got the shadow coming that way, and we want to put a bit of dark. Thin that down a little bit there. Right, that's a bit better. I've got to clean your brushes up now. See you soon. Bye bye.